relative efficiency of estimators. And we are going to try to start an example by hand here after I talk about this. Once again, assume n is fixed. I've got a random sample from a population. Let theta 1 hat and theta 2 hat both be unbiased estimators for theta. So they're both unbiased. Which one is relatively more efficient? It's the one with the smaller variance. At least for that value of n. In theory, for a different value of n, the other one could be more efficient. So this is talking about for a fixed value of n. And the relative efficiency, we say it's relatively more efficient in that context. And the actual relative efficiency is defined to be this ratio. So, you know, the smaller that ratio is, the closer to zero it is, the more relatively efficient theta one hat is compared to theta two hat. And then in the big scheme of things, the big idea is that means theta one hat is a better estimator than theta two hat. We'd prefer using theta one hat compared to theta two hat. Here's an example. Let x1 through xn be a random sample from a uniform distribution on the interval from 0 to theta. Let theta 1 hat be n plus 1 over n times the maximum, and theta 2 hat be 2 times x bar. Let's calculate the relative efficiency. If it's close to 0 for fixed n, that means this is really a better estimate. If it's close to 0 for all n, in fact, it doesn't matter what the sample size is, that means theta 1 half is going to be, in general, better than theta 2 half. Can I do this calculation in 14 minutes? And try. Use Mathematica for help. So I have to compute the variance of these estimators. I'm guessing the variance of theta 2 hat is easier because it depends on x bar. And I know the variance of x bar. I'm guessing that one's easier. Let's try it. So x again is uniform on 0 to theta. Theta 2 hat is what I'm thinking about. That's the 2 times x bar. We know expected value of theta 2 hat, we already showed, is theta itself. We do know it's unbiased. That was what I showed you back here. What's its variance? What's the variance of theta 2 hat? As always, it would be the second moment minus the square of the first moment. And I could try it that way, but I think it's probably easier to use the fact that theta 2 hat is 2 times x bar, and then use the fact that I know the variance of x bar. The variance of theta 2 hat is the variance of 2 times x bar, and by properties of variances, that's 2 squared times the variance of x bar, right? Take the constant out front, but square it. That's a property of variances. In other words, it's 4 times the variance of x bar. But what's the variance of x bar? The variance of x bar is sigma squared divided by n for any random variable that has a finite variance. But this is a special random variable. I should be able to simplify the variance. I do have the formula memorized, but most of you probably don't. So let's look it up in the table. Chapter 4. Uniform distribution is in there. There it is. There's the density when x is between a and b. There's its variance. B minus a quantity squared over 12. Kind of a weird variance to divide by 12. But that is the way it turns out. You can check by doing some integrals. That is the variance. The length of the interval squared divided by 12. What is the length of this interval? It's theta. So it's theta squared divided by 12. Simplifies here then to theta squared over 3n. So that's the variance of this estimator, 2 times x bar in this situation. It does go to 0 as n goes to infinity. That's nice. That means it's a consistent estimator. Theta 2 hat is consistent. But that's not our end goal in this problem. In this example, we're trying to figure out its relative efficiency compared to theta 1 hat. Theta 1 hat, the variance is going to be trickier. Variance of that. If I can figure out the variance of the maximum, then I can multiply by this thing squared to find the variance of theta 1 hat. But how do you find the variance of the maximum? We need to find its distribution. We need to find its PDF. It's not as hard as it sounds. We can use our old friend, the CDF method. For shorthand, let's let, say, W equal the maximum, x1 through xn. What's the CDF of W? Are we ever going to get away from the CDF method? Yeah, we don't use it with regression, but it's still useful right now. If the maximum of n numbers is less than or equal to W, that means all the numbers must be less than or equal to W. Right? Does that make sense? If the biggest of a list of numbers is less than or equal to 10, then all the numbers have to be less than or equal to 10, because if any one of them were bigger than 10, the maximum would be bigger than 10. So I got a bunch of ands here. Oh, our old friend independence comes into play again. Multiply all these probabilities. Begging a question, what are those probabilities? Use the fact that x is uniform on the interval from 0 to theta. Its PDF is 1 over theta. Its CDF is x over theta. Right? Did an integral in my head. Of course, it's 0 when x is less than 0 and 1 when x is greater than theta, but I'm not worrying about writing these as piecewise. So that's the function I use for each of these. Because x1, x2 through xn all have the same distribution as x. They all have the same CDF. So I get a bunch of W over thetas. How many of them? N of them. That is the CDF of the maximum. What's its PDF? Take the derivative with respect to W. get this. We're running low on time. I'm going to have Mathematica do some integrals for me. So the mean is the integral of W times the PDF. What should this equal? Not quite theta. Theta times n over 1 plus n. Oh, there we go. That's why I multiply by n plus 1 over n. Times the maximum to make it unbiased. Not done, I need the variance as well, so I need the second moment. Ignore this part, the if RE of n is greater than negative 1 or negative 2. That's Mathematica is wondering if I intend n to be a complex number or not. That's the second moment. So what's the variance? Second moment minus the square of the first moment. There's the second moment. Or excuse me, no, that's the variance, excuse me. That's the variance of the maximum. With Mathematica, we figured it out to be n theta squared divided by n plus 2 times n plus 1 quantity squared. So that was not the final variance I'm after, though. I'm after the variance of theta 1 hat. Theta 1 hat was n plus 1 divided by n times the maximum. Factor out the n plus 1 over n and square it. Get n plus 1 squared over n squared times the variance of the maximum. Oops, sorry. Variance of the maximum, which we've just found to be this thing. So plug that in here. The n plus one quantity, the n plus one quantity squareds cancel. And one of the n's cancels. After cancellation, it looks like we are left with theta squared over n plus 2. Oh, no, n times n plus 2. One of the n's cancels. Now we're ready to calculate the relative efficiency. Take this variance and divide by that variance. The theta squareds cancel. The n's cancel, actually. This n cancels with this n. The relative efficiency, almost out of room and almost out of time, variance of theta 1 hat divided by the variance of theta 2 hat ends up equaling what? Theta squareds cancel, n cancels on the top. We end up with a 1/3 on the top after cancellation. And on the bottom, we end up with an n plus 2. So it looks like it's 1 over 3n plus 6 for the relative efficiency. What is it on top? Oh, I did it the other way around. I'm sorry. Okay, that was wrong. I mixed up theta 1 hat and theta 2 hat. Multiply the top and bottom by 3. It's 3 over n plus 2. And that's going to be less than 1 if n is bigger than 1. So what's the punchline? The punchline is theta 1 hat's better than theta 2 hat. They're both unbiased, and one is more relatively efficient. Where did I put the paper? Where theta 1 hat and theta 2 hat for theta 1 hat was n plus 1 over n times the maximum. Theta 2 hat was at 2 times x bar. N plus 1 over n times the maximum is better, is what this means. All right. Have a good day.